This has to be one of the best hot water systems you can buy for your camper van. This is Pundmann's brand new hot water heater. It's 10 litres and you can heat it in 4 different ways. In this video, I'm going to fully go over this hot water system, including how we installed it and how it operates when we're on the road, especially in winter conditions where it gets below zero. So there are 4 different ways that we can heat the water inside of this boiler. We have a 240 volt element, a 12 volt element, a coil for your coolant from your engine, and of course your diesel hot air heater. And as you can see, when you buy it straight from the shop, it comes with 1/2 inch threads coming out. So up here we have our hot water, which is a 1/2 inch thread. We have our coil for our coolant from our engine and a 1/2 inch thread for the cold water as well. It does come with a overpressure valve as well, which is 6.9 bar, I believe. And the diesel hot air, you don't have to do anything. You just put a duct simply straight in here and your diesel hot air will just flow straight through. It comes out the other side and it creates hot water. So as you can see on this side, this is where the hot air is gonna come out. We have 2 temperature sensor holes here. This one I believe is an 8mm hole. I haven't taken it out, but you can put in a temperature sensor that way. But this one is a lot easier. It's a 6mm hole and you just slide in a temperature sensor, which goes straight back to your monitoring system, however you monitor it. That way you can get a straight readout of the temperature of your hot water system, so you're not gonna have a shower in cold water. So one of the big reasons we chose this 10 liter hot water system was its shape and functionality. Obviously, when you buy many hot water systems on the market for camper vans, they are a circular type design, which isn't really functional in a camper van, especially if you're going into harsh winter conditions where temperatures are getting below zero. If you mount that circular hot water system outside of your van, chances are it's not going to stay warm for very long. So we needed something we could put inside our van. But the circular model just wasn't really functional at all. We could put it in the back, but then it takes up much more room than what we need, and you can't put anything on top of it because it's just going to slide off. What I loved about this one was that it was a square model and we can basically put it anywhere as if it was just another box in the back of the van. So what we're going to first off do today is put everything on the outside of here. So as you can see, we have these 1/2 inch threads, but we need to have fittings on top of this to connect our hose. So what we've done, we've run the 1/2 inch hose from the front of our engine, which is going to connect to the coolant line, and that's going to come to here, and that's just going to be a hose straight on as a fitting. So on the hot water out, we're going to put a mixer, which basically mixes the water to go out at a certain temperature so you don't burn yourself at a maximum 80 degrees. Because when you're circulating the coolant from your engine, it's going to be coming out extremely hot, upwards of 80 degrees, 90 degrees. So you don't want that going through your pipes. So we're going to put a mixer and to make sure the cold water comes in with a 10 millimeter hose as well. So I bought a lot of fittings, so let's get into that. Okay, so as I said, we have 1/2 inch hose running from the engine to the back of the van, which is gonna plug into this. So we've got here, we have 1/2 inch fittings to a 1/2 inch hose fitting. So this just screws onto there. There are a few different ways you could do this. This one is a hose type fitting, but you could also get a female coupling, which is similar to this, but that doesn't move, it's just going to be stuck in place. So for these, you do need a high temperature sealant for the thread. So here I have a normal plumber's tape or a thread tape. This can actually go up to 120 degrees, I've been told by the retailer. But also I have this one, which is from Germany. It's called Tech 500 and it can go up to 200 degrees. Because this comes straight from the engine, I'm going to choose to use this one this time. But for all these other threads, I'm just going to use a normal plumber's tape as they shouldn't get as hot. Okay, so we have the Tech 500. We're just going to put a little bit on. Don't need much, it is thread sealant, so you just put a little bit on and screw it on. Do the same on the other side. Now we have our mixer and we have our hose attachments, but to get a 1/2 inch onto this, they're both males. As you can see, it won't fit, so we have here a female 1/2 inch coupling. That's just going to go on there, which allows us to screw onto there. And then these ones, it's going to be our hot water in, our cold water in, and our hot water out, or warm water I should say. On all fittings on the hot water system, we are using thread tape and then adding a female to female adapter because you can't use a male to male. On the front side of the mixer, we're adding a hose adapter so our hose can go straight in for the cold water. On the bottom side, now adding some thread tape and an angle piece because the duct for the diesel heater below was in the way, so we put an angle piece in to try and get it out of the way, which worked perfectly. And we took off our overpressure valve and added a T piece and a new one that is down from 6 bar to about 3 bar. Okay, so this is our overpressure valve and this is the T that's going to go on the cold water inside, but unfortunately I forgot to buy a male coupling, which can't put two females together, unfortunately. It's just the way engineering works. But what we are going to do is put this on the bottom and then screw on our hose adapter so the cold water can come in. And then all we have to do is put our overpressure valve on there, cold water comes in there, and then a drain will go on here, which will drain out all the overpressure to below the van onto the road as we drive. So the fittings on the outside going from our water in and our coolant in, and everything is all done. And what we're going to do first is run the coolant lines to the engine of the vehicle all the way to the back where the hot water is going to sit. So we're running half inch coolant lines. We're going to put some insulation around them and try and get them up on the engine. It'll be insulated all the way from the back of the van towards the engine, and then somewhere where it pops up in the engine, I'll stop the insulation there. Okay, so for the heater hose installation, the GoPro died and it didn't actually record me putting the heater hose in, so I'm just going to give you a run through of what I've done. So as you can see here, these two insulated pipes, they're the heater hose that run from the engine to the back of the van. They run all the way along and then pop up somewhere over there. But they're fully covered in insulation all the way along. They originally only came in 3 meter lengths. Every now and then you can see a join. And I've basically just put that in insulation. Instead of using cable ties, I've used steel builder's bracket. And I've just screwed that up to make it a bit more secure. And that's basically how I ran the coolant into the engine and to the back of the van. It was a bit of a mission originally, but yeah. Okay, so what we're doing now is we're putting the coolant lines on the hot water. The other side of the engine side coolant lines are already under the van. So I'm just going to put these on, tighten them up with hose clamps, drill the holes, and then join onto the coolant lines under the van. So what I'm going to do now is just connect the drain line from the overpressure valve. As we heat up the hot water, it's going to let water out, so we need that water to go somewhere. So we're going to put this on, drill a hole through the floor, and then it'll drain out onto the road as we drive. Okay, so I just made up a little thing here for our cold water in. This is where the main cold water is going to come in from. We just have to change this to a one-way valve, but I'll put this in for now. And this one goes to our mixer valve, which goes straight into the cold end side. But we'll put this end on first into our cold water supply, and then we'll do everything on the hot water later. So we lined everything up, we measured it all. So now we're just gonna drill our hole, and we're bringing the insulation and everything up through the hole. It's a 51 millimeter hole, which should be perfect for one pipe. So we're gonna drill two separate holes. So this is what we're using for the insulation around the coolant hoses, as we don't wanna have too much loss of heat from the engine to the back. We put insulation over the whole thing. So this insulation is coming through the floor, and it's going to go all the way over every connection that the coolant goes to, all the way to the insulation of the hot water. Okay, so I'm a bit cramped in here, but we've just put the hot water in. Everything's done. We've got the coolant lines, the insulation's on, but I've just left it exposed. So that way when we put the coolant line into the engine and we connect it all up and we run the coolant through, we want to make sure that there's no leaks. This way I can see exactly on the connection and make sure there's no leaks. But everything else is connected. The diesel heater pipe from my diesel heater, it's basically too short, so we'll have to get another one to make sure it goes all the way into our hot water so we can make hot water while we use the diesel heater as well. These are our hoses coming from the engine. These are the ones from hot water, so we just need to connect them up, put some insulation on them, and they will all be good. Okay, so this is what we're going to use to mount the hot water, to actually fix it to the floor. So you can buy this at any hardware store. It's got holes all in it, so you can put the screws anywhere. So we'll just cut off two lengths of this and strap it down to the floor. Okay, and this is our temperature sensor for the hot water. And there's a hole that's been welded in the side that has a 6mm hole. This just slides straight in. It's got silicon on the outside, so it's not going to melt with the hot temperature. And yeah, that'll tell us our hot water temperature up on the screen on our Simmarine. Okay, so this is our cable from the Simmarine, which I put in the other day. I just have to strip this back. I'm going to be using Vago connectors to connect onto these two together. I just zip tied this across the top of the heater so it doesn't come off and it's not in the way. And that's all we can do for today. Tomorrow we're going to do the coolant lines connected to the engine, drain the coolant and connect it all up, and then hopefully we have no leaks on the coolant line, and that should make us hot water instantly. So I hope you can hear me okay, because it is a bit windy today, but hopefully it's all good. Now we're going to tap into the coolant lines of the vehicle, but at the same time I'm going to drain the coolant from the vehicle and replace it with new vehicle, as well as doing a coolant flush at the same time, because I doubt it has ever been done on this vehicle. So the coolant system inside of the van engine is running 3/8 hose. Our heater hose is 1/2/8. So to cut into that heater hose, you need to use a PVC pipe cutter or a Stanley knife, do a really neat cut, and then find a adapter or something to make it so it's 3/8 this way and then 1/2 inch going out. What I ended up using was a T piece that was threaded, and then I just put on hose adapters on the sizes I needed. But you can get a fixed made brass fitting that is 3/8 and then 1/2 coming out as well. Yeah, so this is the heating matrix you can see here. This is where the pipes go through to the engine to provide heat for the heater. When you turn on the heater, as in the air conditioning heater, that will deliver the coolant to a heat exchange, and a fan blows through that, and then that gives you your hot air. So what we did is we just cut into both of those pipes, put a T-piece in, and then put a valve on the other side as well. That way we can turn the hot water on and off from the engine if we don't need it in summertime for whatever reason, and then we aren't going to be wasting engine heat. So we finally got the last piece of the puzzle to finish off our hot water system. We got the air duct to go from the diesel heater to our hot water, so I'm going to install that, and then finally the hot water is done and completed. Woohoo! This is our diesel hot air here, and basically it's connected to a Y piece in there, so I just need to reconnect it and bring it through the middle into here. This is our new diesel hot air pipe. As you can see, it goes straight in from the Y piece up there, runs down into here. So normally it's a 90 mil that goes around the outside of that little inlet there, but you just put it on the inside and that sits there really well. So I'm just going to leave it like that. Okay, so this morning we're gonna go for a small drive, about 8 kilometers. Takes about 10 minutes, it's not very far. The hot water is currently at 15 degrees, and we're gonna see, driving such a short distance, how high the hot water temperature is gonna go. Okay, so after driving for about 10 minutes, roughly only 8 kilometers, maybe not even that, we are now at 32 degrees in our hot water system. So you can really see that just after driving such a short distance, you really do heat up that hot water a lot quicker. Now when we drive back home, which is another 6 minutes or something like that, or 10 minutes, we'll see what it gets to above that degree as well. Roughly when we shower, we do want the water above 38 degrees because that makes it pretty comfortable. So we'll see if we can get above 38 degrees within, say, 20 minutes of driving or 15 minutes of driving even. And then tomorrow we're gonna be doing a longer trip of around about 4 hours, and we'll see what temperature the hot water gets to then. But in that time, I'm also gonna drain the hot water when we get home, get it back down to 15 degrees, and we'll plug it into 240 volts, and we'll see how that performs. Back from the drive, we drove from Jochberg to Kitzbühel, which is about 5 kilometers, takes about 10 minutes, and we drove back again, and the hot water's gone from 15 degrees to now being at 41. So it doesn't take long, and it really heats up well. So we're just going to test out the 240 volt element in the hot water now. So at the moment we're at 22 degrees in the hot water. I'm going to turn the 240 volts on, we'll put a timer on and see how long it takes till we reach about 60 degrees. So the alarm has just gone off, it reached 60 degrees, and it's been 1 hour since we turned it on. So it's gone from 22 to 60 degrees in about an hour on 240 volt or mains power. Okay, we're starting the 12 volt hot water heater. Starting at 21 degrees, and we'll run it for a few hours and see where we end up. Currently, I think we are using about 10 amps on this. Yep, so we've got a few other things running and it's using about 10 amps of power. Okay, so we've had the 12 volt hot water element on for about 3 hours and we're now up to 45.3 degrees, so it has increased a lot and now we're at about shower temperature. Now let's check the electricity to see how much we've used. And we've gone about 10% down, but that's also with other things going as well. Okay, now we're going to start the diesel heater and heat the hot water with the hot air that comes out of that. So we're at 18 degrees and we'll start that one now. We'll start it on a low setting and just see how it goes. And we'll run it for about 2 hours on low and hopefully the air water temperature will increase in the hot water substantially. Okay, so we've had the heater on for about 2 hours and we've jumped up 25 degrees, so it's very, very efficient. The heater was set on a low setting, so it's only on 3 bars on power mode, so it's not really that high, and we've jumped up about 27 degrees. Okay, so I'm just going to give you a quick summary of how our tests went and everything all combined together and how we like the hot water system so far. So from the tests we've done, these are our stats. If we drive for 20 minutes, it increases about 30 degrees, but this is a very variable sort of test because if we drive up a really steep hill and we're using a low gear and the engine's revving more, it's obviously going to heat up the hot water a lot quicker. If we're driving on a flat ground and not really revving the car in excess, it's going to take a lot longer to heat up the car. If we're driving down a hill and not using the engine at all, basically just cruising down, it's going to take even longer again. So it really depends on how you use the engine and how it's going to heat up the hot water. Okay, so number two was the 240 volt. That increased 40 degrees within an hour. It's a very efficient system when we use 240 volt. We only really use it if we plug in at a campsite or something like that, but it is a very efficient and fast way of heating our hot water system. So number three was our 12 volt system. That increased 25 degrees. And it took about 3 hours to do that. This is the slowest way of heating the hot water, but it is a way and it does work and it doesn't use that much power. Roughly per hour of use, it uses about 10 amp hours, which isn't a great deal. So it does depend when you use this. If you're starting with really cold water, it's going to take a lot longer to warm up the hot water system using the 12 volt system. But if you're in like a warm environment, somewhere like Portugal or Spain, and the water coming out the tap is like 30 degrees or 20 degrees, it's going to go up a lot faster. Okay, and lastly, we have the diesel heater. Took 2 hours to increase roughly 25 degrees. And we did have the diesel heater on low, which means that not much air is getting pushed through there. There still was air getting pushed through the heat exchange, but not as much as what it could be if we were running on high. And if we were running the diesel heater on high, I'm assuming that the increase of temperature in the hot water system would go up a lot faster and a lot more. But for us, we didn't need it to go up that much. So it was okay putting it on low for 2 hours and increasing 25 degrees. Okay, so overall, we really are happy with our Pundmann hot water system. There's four different ways and it gives you four variable options to use. And really in every case scenario, you can use your hot water system regardless of where you are, what you're doing or whatever. So if you are looking for hot water, I highly recommend this one. Go to the website and check it out. Thanks for watching. If you do want to subscribe to the channel and give this video a like and share it to your friends who are in the campervan community.